Hi, I'm Dom, and welcome to my channel, The Metal Muse, where I discuss all things metal. Now, I had some really positive feedback on my previous reaction video to Rammstein's song Adieu, and somebody in the comments actually recommended that I review Deutschland. And seeing as Deutschland's literally one of my most favourite songs of all times, I thought, why the heck not? So let's just do it. Now, I have a basic rudimentary understanding of history. I do have a degree in history, however, it was in Scotland's involvement in the 30 Years' War. So not exactly relevant, but I just thought, let's just do it. I mean, I did see a video one time, but that was like years ago, where an Oxford professor actually like broke down the video, so I'm sure I've forgotten it. So I really feel like right now we're kind of going in fresh, because it's also been a long time since I watched the video. And I feel that if I miss things or if I don't get it, there will be somebody lovely in the comments to help me out. In the last video, there was a guy called Michael Finnick who wrote me the most amazing explanation of the video Adieu and showed me that I had actually missed so many of the inner meanings of the video and things that I should have picked up on and didn't. So Michael, thank you so much for that, and I'm expecting to see you in the comments for this video too. So why not, let's just like get right into it, stop faffing around and just do. Okay, so let's crack on. Okay, red laser again, that was an Adieu. Okay, so we're in Germania, long time ago, in a country not so far away. Wow, look at the costumes. The Romans. Schneider's looking pretty beat up. Listen to that build up. Like, something big is coming, that you can feel it. It's like in War of the Worlds, that sort of noise. What is that? Is there a technical term for that? I'd love to know. Okay, some bodies in the trees. And now we know where Till is. Yeah. Oh. Wait for it. Oh, it's the guy who did Adieu, Spectre Berlin. Cool, I'm really gonna look up his other work. Getting that build up. Astronauts. We're time jumping with this thing. Okay. Were we like in the 1930s? Here we're in the Golden Age. Is this Crusade? I gotta tell you, she looks absolutely stunning, like Joan of Arc, Elizabeth I, you know, Catherine, Queen of Aragon, her mom. Which is actually hair like a fake wig. Okay, there's a hint of her. Okay, she's definitely a flapper, so we 1930s. Or is it the Roaring 20s? Keep your eye. Either way, those mustaches are doing it for both of them. Okay, just a moment. Like, so this model actress, Ruby Commey, so like, I think I'm pronouncing it wrong, C-O-M-M-E-Y. She is so stunning. Like, she's kind of got these Iman sort of looks, but then she's also got that Grace Jones sort of intensity. She's so beautiful, and every look they put her in here, she is an absolute scene stealer. I'm really sorry about the lisping. I've just got Invisalign and my teeth are funny, so sorry. Das Herz in Flammen. That's the hero shot. Oh, the guys are priests. Do you know what? Do you remember they play priests in Rosenrot as well? Like, kind of like monks, kind of like this? Getting a lot of kind of callbacks to their previous videos so far. What's the bit? Children's brother is going to show his basement. He just like had the party's getting lit. The whole jail thing is over my head. I don't know what it means, but it looks cool. Is this like an old school jail, but like modern police? That's fierce car. This is the bit of the video that was very controversial and upset people. And, I mean, I get why, but actually, just as a moment, I get why this upset people. I do, but personally, as a history nerd, they're talking about their country's history, and I'm really glad they didn't gloss over it. I'm glad they didn't just like airbrush it out either. They've definitely addressed it. Now, the other debate people had was whether Rammstein are the appropriate people to be addressing a topic like this, but I think raising awareness is important, even if it's through music. You know, I feel like that last scene was actually quite awful to look at. Like, it's such a horrible moment in history. But then, like, to kind of bring us back, they gave us Till in drag, and really bad drag at that. So thanks, guys. Thanks for bringing us back there. We needed a moment of levity. However, I'm sure probably this is actually something like a quite serious historical moment. So again, somebody educate me. But that hair. It's another kidnapping her. Everything's just starting to cross over, like all the timelines. Okay. Burning women at the stake. Burning books. Gross. Now, which album was it when it was all their heads like white busts? It's gonna bug me now, I have to look it up. Okay, I have to pause it because, right, so I wanted to make a point, like, you see a lot of times, like, you know, like giving birth, references to birth or women being up in the stirrups, and I'm like, okay. A lot of that, and it's a common theme, and I wonder what that actually is all about. Like, is it about rebirth? Is it about, you know, the womb? Is it about Mother Nature? Is it, I don't know, like circle of life stuff? If somebody has some thoughts on that, please let me know. And the next reason I pause this is this kind of coming into church on a horse. Like, it really reminds me of like a Robert the Bruce coming into the church up in St. Andrews. There's just very, or like when a British monarch would die back in like Tudor times, they would I think somebody would come in on horseback, and then they would break their staves of office and throw them in the grave to symbolize the end of the reign. I could be making that up, like legit could just be making that up, but I think I'm right. I feel like I am right. It's been a long time since I was a student, so I'm sorry if my history professor Steve is watching this. I have brought great dishonor and shame upon us. I love how this is just progressing into one insane fever dream. This is just getting more and more and more and more unhinged and debauched and crazy. Oh, that's a double reference. So the wings, right? That's obviously Engel. Like, you, the most basic Rammstein fan will get that reference. But I wonder, do you get the reference from Mindheil with the boys on all fours? Whatever this is. In the Mindheil video, the boys were all on all fours getting led on dog leashes with muzzles up the stairs. I think it was Alexanderplatz. Yeah, like, lifelong dream is to go back and recreate that scene with dogs. Definitely not hot German men. Oh, I love the piano. These are some seriously cute puppies. I hope they weren't traumatized by being in a Rammstein video. Oh, this is all like leads back to Sauna. Like, that's totally Snow White in her glass coffin. And you know what? So at the Rammstein gigs, they have these two wonderful women who are, come and do piano. And yeah, you hear this, like, at the end. It's really nice because it kind of brings everything down. I mean, bloody hell, this. Oh, wait, one second. Can I just sit? Right, this is something really stupid. So, like, see the German Shepherds, right? I grew up with German Shepherds when I was little, and they were such teddy bear dogs. Like, they were complete nanny dogs. And it wasn't until I was much older, somebody, like, actually to discover that they were used as guard dogs and police dogs. Like, that was just over my head. It wasn't something you saw very often where I grew up, like, in Scotland. Like, you just didn't see police dogs all the time. You do now, but, like, yeah, somebody had to be like, yeah, German Shepherds are not teddy bears, but the ones I grew up with, teddy bears. And I still find it really hard to, you know, pair that scary dog with teddy bear dog. I have to look this dude up. I mean, if it's not Elizabeth I with the big ruff, like, who is it? Is she Isabel of Castile? Oh, no. This makes me so sad. But again, I'm glad they didn't shy away from it and pretend it didn't happen. Like, this video, like, every scene, look at every part of this scene. Not a single thing is there by chance. Everything has meaning. And look at the costumes. Like, there are movies out there that wish they had these kind of budgets. I really feel like the guys have moved into this era where they're not just making music, like, they're making art. They're making stuff that people will study in film school. Probably already do. Oh, such a haunting tune. Look at that bird. Look at her, she looks so fierce. And okay, well, that was a roller coaster experience. That was intense. It was everything. As a history nerd, I absolutely adored it. To me, that is, like, it's just a visual feast. I love that they were time jumping. I love that they, you know, touched on, you know, the more difficult periods. I liked the costuming. I liked everything about it, to be honest. I understand why this video might be controversial for some people, but for me, it really was just epic. It was everything I hoped for. And you know what, it's so nice to go back and revisit it. And there's so many shout outs to their old videos. I don't know, I freaking loved it. But I do remember now that I'm thinking about it, the first time I watched it, I cried. Like, yeah, I know. And even just thinking about it, like, yeah. So when they're in the concentration camps, there was just something, like, it's such a horrible part of history, but one we can't forget. but it hit me really raw. Like, I think, yeah. Anyway, I'm rambling, so let's just call it quits, shall we?